They're trying to organise a chase. This is what you were saying, Paul. It's not like a European finish. This is a wide boulevard.
It is a very wide boulevard. Look at that. It's almost like a car race here. We've got everybody in a different lane. They're winding up the gas. 20 seconds is absolutely nothing at speeds like this for the poor old two leaders, because I'm going to have to be the bringer of doom and gloom for those two guys this afternoon. They're not going to survive. The big boys, the sprinters, the gladiators of the route are going to have...
Thank you very much, world champion. We always talked about a world championship, the world championship. Coco on the right of the picture trying to go. He started to dive towards also. Watch Sagan as he comes through here. Because Grönevarden on the left looked as though he got it. Then Wouter Lippert looked as though he's got it. But the world champion said, no, you're all wrong. I got it.
But he was freelancing the whole time and he was timed it in absolute perfection there. Much to the line. It's almost a turn back of the clock to last year when he got himself first third place on the run. Look at this one more time. Sagan is. You can see him in third position there in that white jersey. But watch this last kick. This man has got power. He sees the other two and he's going so much faster. They're judging against each other. Bang on the line. Sagan in for win number one.
This one goes back to what we just were saying. Sitting on the line.
Time.